Hello everyone, today we are going to start next topic in the trend in modern periodic table. Next part is comparing metallic and non-metallic properties in the modern periodic table in a group and a longer period. First of all, have you observed a zigzag line in the periodic table? Yes or no? See the periodic table, there is a zigzag line. Yes or no? Look at page number 86. There is periodic table. Now observe the zigzag line. The elements along this zigzag line are metalloids. Means they are having properties of both metals and non-metals. And on the left hand side of that zigzag line are metals. On the right hand side are non-metals. In the modern periodic table, metals like sodium and magnesium are on the left hand side and sulfur and chlorine on right hand side. In the middle, there is zigzag line. Elements in this zigzag line are boron, silicon, germanium, arsenic, antimony, tellurium, polonium. These are having intermediate properties and are called metalloids or semi-metals. We have silicon in the middle, which is classified as semi-metal or metalloid because it exhibits some properties of metals and some of non-metals. Now, what are metals or metallic character? Metals are those elements which will lose the electrons and got positive charge, or we can say that they can form cations by losing respective electrons. What is its trend in the periodic table? Along a period. As we know, along a period, nuclear charge goes on increasing and they have impact on electron in the outermost shell or valence shell. Along a period, atomic size or radii decreases. What does it mean? Electron losing capacity along a period going from left to right decreases. So, metallic character decreases going from left to right along a period in the modern periodic table. Going down a group. When we go down a group, one shell is being added, atomic size increases, which will dominate the nuclear charge, effective nuclear charge. That's why it becomes easier to lose the electron while going down a group. What does it mean? Means metallic character increases going down a group. Is that clear? Along a period going from left to right. First of all, there are metals, sodium, magnesium, aluminium. Why? Because they will lose respectively 1, 2 or 3 electrons from their valence shell, M shell. Sodium will lose 1 electron, magnesium 2. That's why sodium will form Na positive ion and magnesium will form Mg2 positive ion. Aluminium will lose 3 electron. It will form Al3 positive ion. Means all are cations. Metals are those which will lose electrons. Silicon have 4 electrons in its valence shell, that's why it can't gain or lose. It will share the electron. Phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine. They will not lose electrons. They will gain electrons. That's why metallic character decreases going from left to right. And along a group going from top to bottom. One shell is being added here. That's why distance between nucleus and outermost shell increases and it becomes easier to lose electron from outermost shell as we go down. Means cesium having larger atomic radius or size, electron in the valence shell is far away from the nucleus due to its bigger size. It is easy to lose electron from cesium as compared to lithium and sodium. That's why
cesium in all this periodic table is most electropositive element or metal. We are not taking francium because it is radioactive.
Next one, non-metallic properties. What are non-metals? Those elements which will gain electrons, means their outermost shell have electrons more than 4. They may have 5, 6 or 7 electrons in their outermost shell. That's why they will gain respectively 3, 2 and 1 electron to complete their octet and acquire nearest higher noble gas configuration to become stable or to form compounds. So what is its impact on group or period? First of all, along a period, capacity of gaining electron increases at the end of this period. That's why non-metallic character increases along the period. And going down a group, as we know, atomic size increases down a group, hence capacity to gain electron decreases. What does it mean? While we go from top to bottom, non-metallic character decreases down a group. Now we will deal the nature of oxides. As we know, when metal or non-metal respective element react with oxygen to form oxides. Oxides of metals are basic in nature, whereas non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. What is electronegativity? When the electrons are gained by certain elements to complete their octet, this property is known as electronegativity. And these kinds of elements, means non-metals, are known as electronegative elements.
Non-metallic character, going from top to bottom in a group, decreases among the non-metals. Why? Because one shell is being added and it becomes difficult to accommodate one electron or respectively 2 or 3 electrons in their valence shell. Fluorine among all the non-metal is most electronegative element. And this is all about the variation of the non-metallic character in the group. Now along a period, non-metallic character increases. As we have discussed metallic character up to aluminium, now we will continue here from phosphorus to chlorine. It needs 3 electron. Sulfur needs 2 electron. Chlorine need 1 electron. Why? To complete their octet, to acquire the nearest noble gas configuration of argon. And when any element gain electron, it acquire negative charge. Non-metals form anions. That's why these elements on right hand side of this zigzag line or the metalloid are non-metals and they possess electronegativity. I'm not talking about the group 18 because those are having zero valency. Valence shell is fully filled here. Among all the elements in the periodic table, fluorine is most electronegative. Advantages of modern periodic table. It has made the study of known elements simpler and systematic. Also helped to predict the existence of new elements. It helped in connecting the properties of elements. The position of an element in the periodic table indicates whether it is a metal, non-metal or metalloid. By knowing the position of element in the periodic table, we can predict its atomic number, electronic configuration, valency and properties. It can predict the nature of compounds, ionic or covalent, formed by the element. Thanks for watching.